Hello everyone, so this is the fifth lecture in unit 3 and in this lecture I'll discuss about the continuous and discontinuous mode of operations. So I'll take class A chopper and separately excited DC motor to derive the boundary conditions between the continuous and discontinuous conductions. Okay. So based on the discussion you can also derive for class B 2 quadrant and 4 quadrant base separately excited DC motors. Okay, so that I will leave as an exercise for you. So first I will take pulse width modulation for DC-DC converter. So here you can see this is class A chopper. So class A chopper we can have either by this circuit or this circuit. They are actually equivalent circuits, but there is some difference like isolation requirements of their gate drives, motor current and voltage sensors and gate control circuits. Okay, so there are some different requirement for both these circuits, otherwise their working is same. Okay, so whenever the switch is turned on, so armature circuit is connected with the supply. Okay, so current through this inductor will rise because it is storing energy. So it will rise from some minimum value to the some maximum value. Okay, if we turn off this switch, so to maintain the continuity of the current, it will freewheel through this diode. Okay, now whatever energy stored in this inductor will get dissipated in this armature resistance and also in this diode. Okay, so the current will fall linearly from some maximum value to some minimum value. Okay, so direction of armature current is always towards the armature circuit, so it is working as a motor. Okay, so first quadrant operation, that means both armature voltage, that is voltage across this winding, and current, both are positive and their product will be positive, so power will be positive, that means it is drawing power from the supply. So on time and off time will give you the one switching period. Okay, normally and inverse of this switching period will be the switching frequency. Okay, normally FS or switching frequency, it is in the range of 300 to 1000 hertz for traction drive, which is large power drives, and it is 10 to 20 kilohertz for servo and appliance drives. Okay, that is very small power drives. Okay, so PWM pulse you can again generate with the help of carrier signal and reference signal. So comparison of these two signals will give you the duty cycle. Okay, so whenever this reference signal is higher than the carrier signal, there will be high pulse that is applied to this gate. Okay, and this switch will be turned on. Whenever it is low, the switch will be turned off. Okay, now the frequency of this carrier will give the switching frequency. Okay, at what rate this switch will be turned on and turned off. Now again this PWM modulator you can design like I taken in the advanced power electronic course. So from that you can see how to design the PWM modulator and all those things. Okay, so armature voltage is continuous conduction. So here you can see the armature current is continuous, it is not going to the zero value. Okay, so it is from some minimum value to some maximum value, then from that maximum value to again the initial minimum value. Okay, whenever the switch is turned on, the armature voltage is high, or the armature voltage you can see it is the supply voltage. And whenever the switch is turned off, the armature voltage is zero because the diode, you can see here, the diode will be conducting, so this will be short. Okay, so whatever voltage across this, the same voltage will appear across the armature volt circuit. Okay, so this voltage will be zero if we are considering ideal diodes, so VA will be zero in that case. So we can find what is the armature voltage. So switching period is TS. So from 0 to DTS it is on, and the armature voltage is VS. Then from DTS to TS it is 0. So we are not taking that into account. So we are getting duty cycle times the input supply. Now this armature voltage is not constant, you can see from this. Okay, it is having maximum value, then minimum value, so there will be some ripple. So the ripple content of armature voltage may cause significant losses leading to motor derating. Okay, this also is partly responsible for motor torque ripple and audible noise. The converter type, switching frequency, and armature circuit inductance, these three parameters are selected in such a way that these problems will be fixed to some permissible values. Okay, the ripple in VA or in the ripple in armature voltage are expressed conveniently with RMS values of the harmonic voltage components and a factor that is called ripple factor, that already you learned in the power electronic course 1. So ripple factor, to calculate that we have to compute first the Fourier series component. So Fourier series, the AN and BN factors you can found by using these expressions. Okay, so if you integrate, if you take this waveform, you can found these coefficients, these Fourier coefficients like this. Okay, Vs upon n pi sine 2 pi n d. Bn you can find Vs upon n pi 1 minus cos 2 pi n times d. Now the magnitude of individual harmonic component we can find square root an square plus bn square. Take this square plus this square. Finally you will get this expression. And the harmonic phases you can compute with the help of this tan inverse bn upon an. Just take bn from here and an from this expression, divide that, you will get the phase of each harmonic component. So from this expression you can see the magnitude of the harmonic component will be maximum when d is equal to pi by 2, or d is equal to 1 upon 2. So sine value is maximum at pi by 2. So if d is equal to 1 upon 2, the magnitude of individual harmonic will be maximum. So at duty cycle of 0.5, there will be a maximum ripple value. Okay. So RMS value of ripple current, you can also compute with the help of this value. Okay. From 0 to DTS, we are having Vs. So square it, mean it, then take square root. You will get the RMS value of the armature voltage. Okay, armature voltage RMS value comes to be root D times Vs. So this will be equal to the DC component square plus first harmonic component square, second harmonic component square, like that. And this component can be found from the peak value divided by root 2. So peak value you got from this CN expression. Okay, individual harmonic, for example you want to compute the second harmonics, so n is equal to 2, substitute here, you will get the peak value of the second harmonic. Now to calculate the RMS value, you have to divide by square root 2. Okay, similarly the RMS value of AC voltage across the armature you can find only AC voltage. Okay, we are not taking DC, so we remove this term. Now to compute ripple factor, you have to take AC RMS divided by armature voltage. Okay, if you substitute here VRMS square minus VA square, and you have to divide by armature voltage, you are getting this value. Okay, so VRMS actually you can take from this expression and substitute here minus VA square. Finally you will get 1 minus D upon D. That will be the ripple factor. You can also compute what will be the D value to get maximum value of the ripple. So differentiate this with respect to duty cycle and equal to 0, then compute D value. Okay, you will see that it is 0.5 at which the ripple will be maximum. Okay, so this is important conclusion that you may note down, may be asked in any of the examinations. Okay. Now I'll discuss armature current with continuous conduction. So from T between 0 to T on, you can see here. So once this is T on, this is on. So the armature voltage will be equal to the Vs. So Vs will be equal to drop in this, drop in inductance plus back EMF. So Vs is equal to RAIA plus LA DIA or DT plus back EMF. Now you can solve this this differential equation. So you will get armature current to be Vs minus EA upon RA 1 minus exponential term plus initial value of the current times e to the power minus RA upon LA times T. Now this RA upon LA we call time constant that we represent with tau. So this armature current expression is Vs minus Ea upon Ra 1 minus e to the power minus t over tau plus I minimum e to the power minus t over tau. So if you want to find what will be the maximum armature current, substitute this t is equal to dTs and this Ia will become I max. So Ia max will be Vs minus Ea upon Ra 1 minus e to the power minus dTs upon tau A plus Ia min e to the power minus dTs upon tau A. So this is the maximum value of the current. So we got one expression. Similarly, during interval dTs to Ts, that is switch is turned off. So this diode is conducting. Okay, so this conducting like this. So armature voltage in that case will be 0. Substitute 0 here. RAIA plus LA DIA or DT prime plus EA. We are taking T prime because the time difference now shifted to T minus T on. Okay, we remove that. We have to subtract the on time. Okay, then we will start from that point. So at that point of time, the initial current will be I max and final current will be I min. Okay, now solve this. So we are getting minus EA upon RA. So like that, here if we substitute Vs to be 0, you will get the expression Ia min will be Ia max because it is starting from Ia max. Okay, so simply replace T is equal to T prime and Vs is equal to 0, you will get the, and Ia minimum is equal to Ia max, you will get the expression for off time. Okay, so off time the armature current expression will be minus Ea upon RA 1 minus e to the power minus T prime upon tau A plus Ia max e to the power minus T prime upon tau A. Now T prime you can write like Ts minus dTs. Okay, so total period you have to remove the on time period or 1 minus dTs. Okay, if you take Ts common, that will become 1 minus d times Ts. So if I substitute T prime to be this value, the armature current will be Ia minimum. Okay, so Ia minimum is equal to minus Ea upon RA 1 minus e to the power minus T prime we substitute 1 minus dTs, that is off time, upon tau A plus Ia max e to the power again minus 1 minus d times Ts. We are getting this expression. Okay, now we are again having one expression in Ia min and Ia max. So we are having two expressions. One is this one. In Ia max and Ia min, we are having one expression like this. Another expression we got this one. Now solve these two expressions. So there are two unknowns and two equations. We can solve these two equations to get Ia max and Ia min values. Okay, so Ia max and Ia min values we are getting like this. Okay, if you want to find what will be the ripple in the armature current, so Ia max minus Ia min. Okay, so that will be the ripple value. So subtract these two, we are getting this final expression. Similarly we can also derive the expression for discontinuous current. Okay, so here you can see discontinuous current means there is some interval of time when both this transistor and diode are open circuited. Okay, they do not carry any current. That means armature current becomes zero before next cycle start. So you can see here. So T is equal to T on. The current is rising because this switch is turned on and it is connected to the supply. Now this inductor is storing energy. Okay. Now after DTS time, this switch is turned off and this freewheeling diode will be conducting. So this armature current will flow through this path. Okay. So armature voltage at that time will be zero. Now this IA current becomes zero before next cycle start. Okay. In that case, this diode will be open circuited. And whatever back EMF voltage, the same voltage will be the for armature voltage. So armature voltage in that time will be equal to the back EMF voltage. So you can see here the voltage having three values. So it is having Vs from 0 to T on. Then once this switch is turned off, this diode is conducting, that time the voltage is 0. You can see from here the voltage is 0. Then again this current becomes, this armature current becomes 0. At that point of time, this is open circuited. So whatever back EMF voltage, that will be equal to armature voltage. So armature voltage is equal to the back EMF voltage. Okay. So from this figure, you can say what is the source voltage, that is 250 volt. Then what is back EMF voltage, you can also find from this figure. Okay. Sometimes in the problem, speed is not given. The waveforms are given. From waveforms, you can predict what will be the supply voltage and what will be the speed. Once back EMF is known, you can say what will be the speed, because back EMF is proportional to the speed. Okay, if constant is given, you can find what will be the back EMF voltage or speed. Okay, so you can see from this diagram that the current is rising during on interval, then it is it rises up to some maximum value, then it is falling to zero value. And it is zero, then next cycle starts. Okay, so before next cycle starts, the current, armature current is zero for some time. In that time, the armature voltage will be equal to the back EMF voltage. Okay. Now, if you want to derive the expression for discontinuous conduction, so armature voltage having three values, it is supply voltage. For time interval 0 to DTS, it is 0 for time interval DTS to T gamma. Okay, then the current, armature current becomes 0, so back armature voltage will be equal to the back EMF voltage, and that is from T gamma to TS. Then again next cycle will start. Okay, so it is having Vs 0 and EA, three values. Okay, so you, if you want to find what is average value of the armature voltage, you have to integrate armature voltage in one period. So I am taking 0 to TS. TS is time period. So substitute this. You have to break this in integration into three parts. So first part will be 0 to DTS. You have to substitute Vs in that part. Plus DTS to T gamma, you have to substitute 0. Plus T gamma to TS, you have to substitute EA. If you solve that integration, you will get dVs plus 1 minus T gamma upon TS times EA. Okay. Also, you can find what will be the RMS value of the armature voltage. So, root mean square value. So, first I have to take mean. So, 1 upon TS and integration. So, you have to square the function. So, from 0 to DTS, the function is Vs. So, square that. So, Vs square 0 to DTS. Then T gamma to TS, it is EA square, and DTS to T gamma, it is 0. So 0 we have neglected here. We are not taking here. Now solve this value, you will get this expression. Okay. It can be shown that the Fourier components of the armature voltage with this continuous conduction. So you can find what is the Fourier coefficients. Okay. From this waveform, you have to do the Fourier analysis and you will get the coefficients like this. Okay, so Vs upon n pi like this, Bn is this. So individual harmonic components, you can find their magnitude. Okay. So if I want to compute the armature current in discontinuous conduction mode, so during 0 to dTs, the expression for current will be this one, because I minimum is 0. So if you see the last expression, this one, okay. So in this armature current, actually this value is 0 because this is discontinuous operation. Okay, so I minimum value we are taking 0. If substitute that, you will get the expression for armature current. Okay. So IA is Vs minus EA upon RA 1 minus minus T upon e to the power minus T upon tau A. If you substitute T is equal to dTs, you will get the maximum value of the current. So maximum value of the current is Vs minus EA upon RA 1 minus e to the power minus dTs upon tau A. So minimum current here it is 0, maximum current you compute with the help of this expression. Okay. Now during freewheeling period, that is from dTs to T gamma. Okay. Now I shifted time, so I'm taking T prime. Okay. And Vs is 0 because freewheeling diode is shorted in that period of time. So Vs we have taken 0. So that is minus E upon RA 1 minus E to the power minus T prime upon tau A. Okay. Now initial current is I max in this case. Okay. So I max E to the power minus T prime upon tau A. Okay. If you want to find, so you have to substitute this time. Okay. So that time will be total time minus DTS time. On time, if you subtract that, that will be T prime. If we substitute here T minus dTs in place of T prime, we are getting this expression. Now again, at T is equal to T gamma, armature current becomes 0. So we substitute 0 current here, and here T is equal to T gamma we have to substitute. Okay. Then solve it, we will find what will be the T gamma time. This time is very important. Okay, because this will tell the boundary condition for continuous and discontinuous mode of operation. Okay, if this T gamma is equal to 1 minus dTs, so that will be critical value of duty cycle. Okay, if T gamma is less than 1 minus dTs, that means it will be discontinuous mode of operation. Okay, so if you compute T gamma, if you know this time, you can find whether it is continuous mode of operation or discontinuous mode of operation. So we can find the expression from this T gamma value. Just see here. So we substitute T gamma is equal to 1 minus dTs here and solve it. We can find the duty cycle expression. Okay. So this expression we find. So this is the critical value case. Okay. So here D prime is the duty cycle at the boundary between continuous and discontinuous conduction for a given back EMF or for a given speed. Okay. Back EMF means the speed, because in separately excited motor, flux is kept constant. So back EMF is proportional to the speed. So this D prime we can find by setting T gamma. If T gamma time is Ts, so that will be the boundary time, boundary condition. Okay. So if duty cycle, any duty cycle you are operating beyond the critical duty cycle, then the conduction is continuous. If it is less than the critical duty cycle, then the conduction is discontinuous. So at different duty cycles, the conduction, the characteristics, speed torque characteristics are drawn. Okay. So speed on the y axis and torque on the x axis. So you can see here. So this point actually, this is the boundary between conduction and discontinuous conduction. Okay. So you can see here for higher duty cycle, if load is small, that is torque is small, still we are having continuous conduction. Okay. But if duty cycle is small, at low torque value or at low load value, the conduction may become discontinuous. Okay. So you have to consider both load value and duty cycle. Okay. If load is very small, duty cycle must be high. if load is high, then at low duty cycle also the conduction may be continuous. Okay, so this discussion you can read from this. So the armature inductance, or rather the time constant, has important role in determining the conduction of current in the armature. The higher the inductance, the lower is the likelihood of discontinuous current. Okay, so more inductance value of the armature circuit means there will be more possibility of continuous conduction. Once T gamma is found, the DC value of armature voltage is then easily calculated. It should be noted that with discontinuous conduction, motor speed drops more rapidly. You can see from this characteristic. So, you see, discontinuous mode of operation, the speed regulation is very poor because it is falling at a fast rate. Then in continuous conduction, it is almost constant. A small drooping characteristic. But in discontinuous conduction mode, you can see here that the drooping is very high. Okay. So this is important point you should note down. In discontinuous conduction, motor speed drops more rapidly with increase of load torque or armature current, okay, implying poor speed regulation. Rise of speed during discontinuous conduction also implies loss of gain of the converter supplying the armature. And discontinuous conduction should be avoided by proper selection of armature inductance and switching frequency. The motor inductance and switching frequency are normally so chosen that the armature current remains continuous for the lightest load. Okay, if it is continuous for lightest load, for higher load it will obviously will be continuous. Note that these two items cannot often be chosen freely because there are practical and cost constraint also. So normally we have to, this is a design problem to choose judicially. Okay, now I'll take one problem. So there is class A chopper fit, this is a separately excited motor. So rated value of the armature voltage is given 250 volt, armature resistance is given 2.5 ohm, armature current rated value is given 20 ampere. So it is operating in first quadrant. Okay, and switching frequency is given 400 hertz. With the rated voltage and rated torque applied, the motor speed or rated speed is 600 RPM. So first we have to calculate the duty cycle motor at 300 revolution per minute. Okay. So first part is load torque is unchanged. That means we have to take the rated value of the armature current. Second part, it is reduced by 50%. So that means the armature current will be reduced by 50%. So in second part, you have to take rated value of armature current as 10 ampere. Then second part of the problem is, you have to calculate the minimum value of the inductance in the armature circuit. If the peak to peak ripple in the armature current is not to exceed 10% of the rated armature current. Okay. So these two problems will solve. So first part is very simple. So first we have to calculate the speed in radian per second. So 600 RPM is given. We have to divide it by 60 by 2 pi. So we are getting 62.8 radian per second. Now at the rated value, we have to find what will be the motor constant. So rated value, the speed is 600 RPM. Armature voltage is given. So V is equal to IaRa plus back EMF. Simple equation. So V is equal to Ia drop in this and back EMF, because at a steady state the drop in this inductance will be zero. Okay. So 250 is equal to IaRa plus motor constant times omega, because flux is constant. So that constant we clubbed with the motor constant. So we are writing it as Ke. So 250 is equal to rated armature current is given 20, armature resistance is given 2.5. Omega is, we have found that it is 62.8. okay, so we are getting constant to be 3.18 volt per radian per second. Now we have to find the duty cycle. So omega 2 is given, that the speed is given, the load torque is unchanged and the speed is 300 rpm. So at 300 rpm we have to find the armature voltage. Okay, so va2 is equal to ia2 ra plus ke omega 2. So again, rated value of armature current you have to take because the torque is at rated value. So 20 into 2.5 ohm plus ke is given 3.18. We actually calculated this value, so 3.18, then omega 2 300 rpm, so we again converted into radian per second, so that is 31.4. so armature voltage at that speed actually 150 volt. Now you can find what will be the duty cycle. Okay, so duty cycle directly proportional to armature voltage. So 150 divided by 250. 250 is the rated value, so you can find if armature voltage is 250, duty cycle will be 1. But if armature voltage is 150, what will be the duty cycle? So it is 60%. Now in second part, if you see, in second part you have to reduce, actually you have to take 50% of the armature current. Okay, so 50% means you have to take 10 ampere. So we have to take 10 ampere, we have to again find what will be the armature voltage. Okay, at that speed, that is 31.4 radian per second. Substitute here, you will get the armature voltage, that is 125 volt. Now 125 upon 250, that will give 50% of the duty cycle. Okay, now second part, you have to calculate the minimum value of the inductance in armature circuit. Ripple is given, so first you have to derive the expression for ripple. So I max value expression was this, I minimum expression was this, so difference in these two will be this one. Okay, now if we multiply both by this term, we are getting this final expression for ripple volt current. Okay, so if you again simplify it, we are actually having this expression. Okay, now e to the power ts upon tau a, if we take x square, so this term will become minus 2x. Okay, this term will become x square minus 1. So if you simplify like this, you are getting this expression. So this is actually x minus 1 whole square expression. Substitute here, so x minus 1 from this will be cancelled. So we are getting x minus 1 upon x plus 1, and at this side you can take delta Ia times Ra upon Vs. Delta Ia is given 10% of the armature current. So 10% means 0.1 Ia. Armature voltage, resistance is given, Vs is given to be 250. Okay, now you can find what will be x. So simply cross multiply these two, collect the terms and solve for x. X we are getting this value. Now again resubstitute the x value, so x is e to the power 0.5 ts upon tau a, that is this value. Now again simplify this, we are getting, because this time period is given, okay, frequency is given, so time period is given, so we can find what will be the armature winding constant, time constant. Okay, tau a we can find, so this value we are getting this. Now tau a is La upon Ra, armature resistance is given. So finally we can find what will be La value. Okay, so in next class I will solve some more problems, then that will end our unit 3. Okay, so this week I will start unit 4 as well. Thank you for your attendance.